No, lady. Toys are friends. They're not chew toys. Stop it. Stop it. Nah.
Hey, you guys. Me, Actral77, back here again and here to review Toy Story 4. Non-spoilers, okay? Our story begins with Woody, who decides to take it upon himself to go with Bonnie on her first day orientation to first grade. And basically, by the time they get back from her first grade orientation, Woody introduces everyone to her new little creation, a new little friend, a new toy, if you will, and that is Forky. And Forky doesn't want to be alive. And after introducing Forky to everyone, Woody also mentions that Bonnie and, you know, her family and everyone are going on a road trip, which sounds like fun, right? But since Forky does not get why he's alive, he keeps questioning it. He keeps trying to pretty much throw himself in the trash on a constant basis. So one night, while Woody just passed out, Forky, as again the family are driving, Forky decides to jump out the window. And of course Woody freaks out because this is Bonnie's new toy that she loves. He decides to hop out the window and try to save Forky. Luckily, they end up in a very small town where that was their next stop, pretty much. They're gonna hang out. So Woody is trying to look for Forky all around the place in this small little town to bring him home, when all of a sudden he runs into Bo Peep. And to be honest with you, I'll leave it at that, because after that, of course, there's some villains and some shenanigans. Again, no spoilers, let's just talk about it. I'm not gonna lie to you guys, when I first heard that Pixar was working on Toy Story 4, I was a little nervous, okay? Because again, they just ended it so well on, you know, on the last one, the third one, like just on a perfect, you know, nice little knot. So, and especially because before that time, they have done sequels, which were meh. Like, I couldn't stand Cars 2 and Monsters, Inc. 2. I kind of liked, but again, it was just nothing, you know, worth doing. Again, wasn't excited. So today, guys, I finally saw it, and Pixar, you fucking did it again. This is just such a nice story, a very like heartfelt story, and a very heartfelt Toy Story. And just so you guys know, this is mainly the Woody's story. Like, you do see some of the other characters, but this is just mainly focused on him, especially him and his relationship with Bo Peep, and of course his relationship with Forky. And since we are talking about Forky now, Forky is actually a really interesting character, because again, Bonnie made Forky. Like, again, he's just a spork, clay, sticks, and a couple of pipe cleaners. And it's a pretty grown up story. Like, again, this little character is just asking why he's alive. Like, all he knows is to be thrown in the trash. Like, there's this run-on joke of him just like dumping himself in the trash, and Woody like throwing him out, saying, "Just play with Bonnie, damn it," you know. And I just thought that was really interesting, especially when Woody had to explain to him like what it means to be a toy, or be, you know, someone's like favorite plaything, and, you know, always wanting to be there for him. And we also see Bo Peep again, and her arc in this movie is just fantastic. I didn't know what they were gonna do with her in this one, and again, I'm trying to keep it, you know, no spoilers, but just what she's been going through is really cool. Definitely, it is a great you know, contrast to what Woody has been going through. I'm glad Pixar brought her back just for this story, and it did really feel like it went with it. It didn't feel out of place. It didn't feel like she just popped in. It felt natural to the story. Oh, and another thing I forgot to mention was the villain. The villain is actually really cool. She also had an awesome arc. Her name is Gabby Gabby. She's just this little baby doll that, you know, people, you know, play tea parties with. But she is pretty threatening and pretty creepy, especially with those puppets. And I gotta hand it to the animators that animated those little like wooden puppets. They felt like that's how they would move if they were walking on their own, like with their flabby arms. They kind of look like a drunk person, almost kind of like the Titans from Attack on Titan, which they're kind of based off of drunk people walking alone at night. In other words, drunk people walking around at night are creepy. Let's just face it. Oh, and just to mention again, this movie is more focused on Woody more than anything. We do get some of the side characters, but not as much. I don't know if you guys know this, but known fact about Toy Story 4. The voice actor for Mr. Potato Head did pass away before they even, you know, recorded the voices or even start production on this. And what was cool that I kind of wanted to see in this movie is I heard that the family came out to Pixar and told them, like, hey, you know, my father, the daughter of, Mr. Potato Head was like, he is Mr. Potato Head. Is there any way you could put him in there? Like, is there any voice clips left over? And what's cool is Pixar actually went through their catalog from all the three movies and all the video games they've been putting out and actually used some of the audio from the video games and the movies into the actual, you know, film Toy Story 4. But unfortunately, he doesn't talk much. He mainly just says a couple of lines. Unfortunately, I was a little disappointed that I wanted to see what they could do with, you know, again, all the archived, you know, voice acting from the actor that played Mr. Potato Head. That was kind of a little disappointed me a little bit. But again, it was just nice to hear his voice a couple of times because he is Mr. Potato Head. Just thought I should let you guys know. I've been singing his praises, talking about the characters. Everyone's great, you know. Again, I want to point out, everyone's great in this film. Just putting it out there. But is there anything wrong with Toy Story 4? There is, but it's just minor nitpicks. It's more like the villain, Gabby. I could see what was going to happen to her a mile away. Like, you'll be able to tell what's going to happen. And I just wish I had more interactions with the other characters, because on the last one, which was Toy Story 3, I thought, you know, that was a perfect bow. Again, it was a perfect tie into everything. And it pretty much involved every single character from Toy Story. So I thought, like, it was kind of weird coming into this one that, like, it just mainly focused on Woody. It was nice, don't get me wrong, I love Woody. But I just wish I would have had more interactions with, you know, everyone else. You know, some of the comedy was hit and miss. I love Doom Kaboom, which is played by Keanu Reeves. He's awesome.
Can I pick up the figure? I'm not kidding either.
I also like Ducky and Bonnie. Those guys were really hilarious. Not gonna lie to you, the only thing that irked me about them was why do they have to keep doing a sassy black character? I'm just putting it out there. Like, why does every character like to have to be sassy? But luckily, they're hilarious. They kind of like stole most of the scenes. But again, that was just a minor nitpick from those two characters. But again, they also steal the movie a couple of times. There's an ongoing gag in the movie that I just loved. They're kind of morbid sometimes. Again, I do want to apologize to you guys. I'm sorry if I seem like, you know, all over the place. It's just that, one, don't want to spoil this movie for you. Two, when coming out of the movie theater, I really liked it. I kind of love it, but I don't know if I like it as much as 3, just because 3 was more mainly about all the toys, whereas this one is mainly focused on Woody and, you know, his interactions with Bo and Forky. But then again, I really do love the message in Toy Story 4 about, you know, like, about Forky's, you know, being, like, why is he alive? You know, what's his purpose? I do love the message it was put into this, and again, it got me with the tears. It did. And you know what? I love the interactions with everyone, and this was so fulfilling. You know what? I'm probably going to go see this again, so for that, I'm going to give Toy Story 4 a 5 out of 5. You guys shouldn't have missed this. Go ahead and catch it. You know you already bought a ticket. You already know you're on your way there watching this. So that's about it, guys. This has been Iron Turtle Reviews, and catch you guys next time. Hey guys, hold on 1 second. I do have a little short message for you guys. I do apologize for missing a lot of movies and not putting up reviews faster, or even most reviews. I'm still working on that. And also, again, I have my other job I have to do. I've been working late, so I've been a little bit exhausted. So I do apologize for that. But I'll keep giving you guys updates on what's going on. But again, if you guys like this review, please hit that subscribe button so you can see more of my reviews. Hit that little bell icon so you know when they're dropping, you know? Especially because I'm a little late to the game. And also, if you want to see some other updates, please follow me on Instagram. You can see bloopers, behind the scenes stuff, and see what the heck I'm doing. And yeah, that's about it. See ya!